Hare Krishna. We're waiting for some reason.
I'm waiting that you start, Maharaj.
Oh, nobody's going to introduce? Nothing?
Oh, that I'm not the organizer.
I've been waiting for some host to come on and speak something.
Mole se bakte iskon rijeke da predstave Maharaja za program. Hare Krishna.
Okay. Should I begin? Is it line by line translation or do I just continue speaking?
Maharaj, my humble obeisances is I'm not the organizer, so I don't know what's happening.
Maharaj Vinata is here. Please accept my humble obeisances. I have been engaged for the translation, but they said it cannot be simultaneous because of some technical problems.
I'll speak and then you'll translate, right?
Yeah, it looks like that.
Okay. Om Gyan Timirandasya Gena Jena Salakaya Chaksu Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimakti Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tinamine. Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine. Nirvisesa Sunyavari Pastyatya Devi Sitarine. Panchakalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaivacha Nitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namaho Namaha. Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasati Gaur Bhaktavrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we decided to speak a little on the glories and practice of chanting of the holy names of the Lord.
Odlučili smo govoriti o slavama pjevanja svetog imena i praksi pjevanja svetog imena gospodina.
So this is a broad topic and of course devotees have heard so many different understandings of the glories of the holy name and the practice of Krishna consciousness, but there's always more that we can understand and improve upon.
Ovo je opširna tema o kojoj su bhakte već puno čuli o slavama svetog imena i praksi svjesnosti Krišne, ali uvijek ima nekih novih stvari koje možemo razumjeti i proširiti svoj uvid.
Mm-hmm. And the acharyas and the shastras, and especially his divine grace, Srila Prabhupada, makes a lot of emphasis on the foundation for our progress is situated fully on the chanting of the holy names.
Acharya i Shastre, a naročito osnivač Acharya Srila Prabhupada, naglašavaju koliko je sva naša praksa utemeljena na mantranju svetog imena.
And that chanting is not simply following a particular description. It is the opportunity to connect with Krishna through his holy name.
To mantranje nije samo neka mehanička radnja, već je prilika da se povežemo sa Krišnom kroz njegovo sveto ime.
I'll just mention a few verses which I think are fundamental for our understanding, because the more we know about the glories of the holy name and the more we know about how it is central to the practice of bhakti, the more we are inspired to chant and to improve our chanting.
Spomenut ću nekoliko kritica koje mislim da su jako važne za našu praksu, jer što više znamo o slavama svetog imena, to smo više inspirirani da mantramo i da unaprijedimo svoje mantranje.
In the Kali Santara Upanishads, it says, Iti sodasakam nam nam, Kali kama sanasana, nata parate opayo sarva vedeshu drishyate. After searching through all Vedic literatures, one cannot find a more sublime and more direct process for self-realization than chanting these 60 names, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
U Kali Santarana Upanishadi je rečeno da nakon što pretražimo svu vedsku književnost, nećemo znači postupak koji je uzvišeniji i učinkovitiji od ovog mantranja ovih 16 riječi Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So when we know how important it is that the holy name is that guiding factor or the principle of devotion, which takes us closer and closer to perfection and Krishna conscious, we become more inspired. We become more inspired to chant.
Kada znamo koliko je sveto ime od suštinske važnosti u našem postupku predanog služenja i koliko nas sve bliže i bliže dovodi Krišni, onda postanemo sve više inspirirani u želji da mantramo.
We have to hear about the glories of the holy name regularly, every day.
Moramo redovito svakodnevno slušati o slavama svetog imena.
And we have to chant under with the faith that by chanting the holy names of the Lord, all the spiritual progress that I need is found within that process of chanting.
I moramo mantrati sa vjerom da je u tom mantranju svetog imena sve što nam je potrebno za duhovni napredak.
With that faith, we're inspired to improve the quality of our chanting.
Takvom vjerom bit ćemo nadahnuti da poboljšamo kvalitetu svog mantranja.
Because approaching Krishna's name is approaching Krishna. Krishna's name is non-different.
Jer kad prilazimo Krišninom imenu, prilazimo Krišni, jer se Krišna i njegovo ime ne razlikuju.
I mean, do we really understand that clearly?
Da li to stvarno jasno razumijemo?
I mean, we hear it so many times through lectures, through books, through other people. How much do we really understand that Krishna and his name are non-different?
Toliko puta smo to čuli u knjigama, u predavanjima i od drugih ljudi, da se Krišna i njegovo ime ne razlikuju. Ali koliko to zaista razumijemo, drugo je pitanje.
That understanding will come through the process of chanting, but before we reach that stage of realization, we can accept it on the basis of how others have made advancement in their spiritual practice.
Do te spoznaje ćemo doći putem mantranja, ali prije nego li što se to dogodi, možemo je prihvatiti na temelju toga kako su drugi napredovali u svojoj duhovnoj praksi.
And one of the most important parts in the process of chanting is attention.
A jedan najvažniji dio u tom postupku mantranja je pažljivost.
We have to work on becoming as attentive as we can in chanting.
Trebamo raditi na tome da dok mantramo budemo što je pažljivije mogući.
The tendency of the mind is to wander to others' thoughts and subjects, or think about other things that we have to do, or things that we haven't done and we want to do.
Um je sklon tome da odluta na različite teme i različite druge misli da se u njemu pojave ili da razmišlja o tome što smo napravili ili što nismo napravili.
So if we want to maximize the effect of our chanting, we have to be completely focused on the chanting and nothing else.
Ako želimo dobiti najviše od svog mantranja, onda moramo biti usredotočeni samo na mantranje i ni na što drugo.
Now, a lot of us chant in our own homes.
Mnogi od nas mantraju kod sebe kući.
And that can also cause distraction.
I to može biti uzrok smetnji nekih.
If we're in an environment that we're familiar with, the objects that are around us, and the atmosphere itself can cause us to be distracted very easily.
Jer kada smo u okolišu koji poznajemo i oko nas su nam poznate stvari, one vrlo lako mogu odvući našu pažnju.
And that distraction will take away from the benefit of chanting.
I zbog toga, zbog te smetnje, nećemo dobiti sve dobrobiti od mantranja.
Chanting is sweet because chanting is not different than Krishna. I mean, all of Krishna's qualities are found within his name.
Mantrenje je slatko jer se mantrenje ne razlikuje od Krišne, a sve Krišnine osobine su u njegovom imenu.
So if we're somehow rather affected or distracted by our environment, the tendency is that we, instead of staying focused on the chanting, our mind goes in and out from hearing to other thoughts to distractions.
Međutim, ako smo u okolišu koji nas na neki način ometa u tome da budemo pažljivi, onda će umu se pojaviti različite misli koje će smetati da budemo pažljivi.
So we use a little cliche, when I chant, I chant. In other words, I don't do anything else.
Možemo ponoviti jednu običajnu stvar, ta je da kad mantram, onda samo mantram, ne radim ništa drugo.
Turn off the cell phone, keep the computer closed, keep yourself in an environment where there's the least amount of distraction.
Isključite telefon, zatvorite računalo i budite u okolini u kojoj ima najmanje potencijalnih smetnji.
And just try to hear.
I samo pokušajte čuti.
Because as the hearing process increases, so does the meditation upon the holy name. And as the holy name becomes continuous, then we start to actually taste the happiness or the sweetness that comes from chanting.
Što više slušamo, to se više usredotočujemo na sveto ime i onda postajemo, sve više doživljavamo njegovu slatkoću, doživljavamo taj pravi rezultat mantrenja.
Srila Bhakti Vinoda Kaur mentions that there are three forms of inattention.
Srila Bhakti Vinoda Kaur spominje da postoje tri vrste nepažnje.
One is called vikshepa. Vikshepa means distractions, thinking about things that are not related to our chanting. In other words, thinking about material things.
Prvi od njih je vikšepa, što znači smetnja, ometanje, što podrazumijeva da razmišljamo o stvarima koje nisu povezane s našim mantranjem, odnosno materialnim stvarima.
So Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, wherever and whenever the mind wanders due to its unsteady and flickering nature, one should carefully bring it back under the control of the self.
Bhagavad Gita Krishna savjetuje da kad god i gdje god odluta zbog svoje treperave prirode, trebamo ga vratiti natrag pažljivo, ga trebamo vratiti natrag pod kontrolu duše.
Chanting is an active process. In other words, we have to be actively involved in trying to hear nicely and put as much attention in our chanting as we can.
Mantranje je aktivan proces, što znači da trebamo uložiti napor u to da pažljivo slušamo, da što pažljivije slušamo.
We shouldn't be lackadaisical or routine or ordinary or mechanical. We should be very active in trying to hear. And at the same time, chanting is a process of offering our devotion to Krishna.
Ne trebamo to raditi mehanički kao neku rutinu ili onako nevoljko, nemarno. A istovremeno je to i proces kojim Krišni nudimo svoju predanost, svoju devociju.
Krishna is attracted by our devotion.
Krišna privlači naša devocija.
And he'll manifest his presence within your mind and within your heart through the holy name. The more you chant in that mood of devotion.
Što više mantraš u tom duhu devocije, to će se on više pokazati u tvom umu, u tvom srcu, u svetom imenu.
Sometimes we say, chant from the heart. In other words, connect your sound vibration of the holy name with the mood of devotion coming from the heart.
Ponekad kažemo mantra iz srca, što podrazumijeva da mantranje svetog imena povežemo sa tim raspoloženjem devocije, predanosti koje imamo u srcu.
And that won't happen right away. That's something you have to work on. You have to be determined to somehow come to that stage of be able to stay focused on hearing. Therefore, it takes time.
To se neće dogoditi odmah. Treba će vremena dok dođemo na taj stupanj da se možemo samo usredotočiti samo na slušanje. Za to treba vremena.
So I meet devotees, they get discouraged. They don't want to chant because they're saying, well, I don't feel anything from chanting. There's no taste from chanting. So they give up their chanting or they just chant mechanically.
Susrećem bakte koji odustaju od mantranja jer kažu da ništa ne osjećaju pri tome dok mantraju, da ništa ne doživljavaju i onda ili odustanu ili jednostavno nastave mantrat, ali samo mehanički.
But Krishna is not so easy, so it takes time and it takes some effort to actually come to the point where we can stay steady in our chanting.
Ali doći do Krišne nije tako lako, treba vremena i truda dok ne dođemo do točke u kojoj možemo biti postojani u svom mantranju.
Prabhupada has said that quantity helps to develop quality.
Šla Prabhupada je rekao da količina pomaže da se razvije kakvoća, kvaliteta.
In other words, if we're stuck on just chanting 16 rounds, if that's our vow to our spiritual master, and we don't chant any more than that, we may not really develop our chanting.
Drugim riječima, ako zaglavimo samo na tome da mantramo samo 16 krugova koliko smo obećali duhovnom učitelju, i ne više od toga, onda možda i nećemo baš razbiti svoje mantranje.
In other words, we should try to chant as much as we can.
Drugim riječima, trebamo pokušati mantrati što više možemo.
Well, sometimes we say, well, I don't have the time.
Ljudi će kad reći, nemam vremena za to.
And we have other things that I want to do or need to do.
Imam druge stvari koje moram raditi ili želim raditi.
And a lot of times we just try to finish our rounds so we can get into doing what we want to do or need to do.
I puno puta želimo samo završiti krugove kako bismo se mogli početi baviti s onim što moramo ili želimo.
And if you have that attitude, Krishna, he knows your heart. So he's not going to reveal himself through the holy name if you're so eager just to finish so you can go on to something else.
I ako imate takav stav, Krishna koji je u srcu, koji zna, poznaje vaš stav, nije baš spreman razotkriti se onome koji mantra samo da bi dovršio te krugove.
This is a symptom of the mode of passion. The mode of passion dictates that by doing something, I get something done. But by chanting, what am I getting done? I don't see any results.
To je guna strasti pod utjecajem koje se razmišlja. Radim nešto zato da bih dobio rezultat. A kad mantram, izgleda ništa ne dobivam, nikakav rezultat.
And this is just a mentality that develops because we see success in life by what we can do rather than the idea of chanting, which we don't really see any results, or sometimes there's no taste.
Pa tako razmišljamo, onda razmišljamo o tome da je uspjeh ono što se vidi prema onome što možemo napraviti. A pritom nam u tu kategoriju ne spada mantranje, jer ne vidimo da donosi neki rezultat, a nemamo čak ni ukusa.
So one thing we can do is become determined and by making a vow that I will chant attentively, I will chant with devotion.
U toj situaciji možemo napraviti jednu stvar, možemo dati zavjet, možemo odlučiti da mantraću pažljivo, mantraću s devocijom.
And when we make that vow, then Krishna says, oh, this person's serious, they really want me. So Krishna helps, he guides us.
Kad damo takav zavjet, Krishna onda vidi, ova osoba je ozbiljna, ona me želi i onda nam pomaže, vodi nas.
And it may take time.
No, može potrajati.
But it's that time is actually, even though we may be getting to the point of attentive chanting, while we're getting there, we're still making progress because Krishna is seeing, oh, this person is trying to chant nicely. Therefore, Krishna accepts that. In other words, Krishna is pleased by our efforts.
I prije nego što smo potpuno savršeni u pažljivom mantranju, mi zapravo napredujemo, jer Krishna vidi našu odlučnost i trud koji ulažemo u to da napredujemo i s tim je zadovoljan.
So, but then when we should never become discouraged if we're not feeling the happiness for chanting. Continue to chant and continue to try to remove those things that cause us to be inattentive.
Ne smijemo nikad biti obeshrabreni time što ne osjećamo neku sreću od mantranja. Trebamo nastaviti mantrati dalje I pokušavati ukloniti one stvari koje nam odvlače pažnju.
Because when you start developing a taste for chanting, then you understand it's a complete different world than chanting without the taste. It's like two different activities. Although the activity is the same, the experiences are quite opposite.
Kad počnete razvijati ukus za mantranje, onda vidite da, su, da je to jedan posve novi svijet. Iako je postupak isti, mantranje, ali doživlja je prilično različit od onog kada mantrate bez ukusa.
And things that we can do to help to improve the quality of our chanting is before we begin our chanting, and even while we're chanting, we can offer prayers to Srila Prabhupada, to our spiritual master, to Lord Chaitanya. We can pray also directly to the Holy Name.
Ono što možemo napraviti je da dok mantramo ili prije nego što počnemo mantrati, odamo poštovanje Srila Prabhupadu, gospodinu Chaitanji, našim acharyama I možemo se moliti ravno I svetom imenom.
One particular prayer that I use every day before I begin is a prayer to Srila Haridas Thakur.
Ovu molitvu koju ja koristim svakodnevno, ta molitva je Srila Haridas Thakuru.
Srila Haridas Thakur is Namacharya and he has mastered the chanting of the holy name. And he is a mercy manifestation of the name who can bless the devotees with better chanting.
Srila Haridas Thakur je Namacharya, on je ovladao mantranjem svetog imena. Inkarnacija je milosti koja može blagosloviti mantrača.
I'll recite the prayer just to give you a little indication of what is the nature of prayers that we can offer.
Izrecitirat ću ovu molitvu da vam pokažem kakva je priroda tih molitvi koje možemo upućivati.
The prayer goes, O Vaishnav Thakur, alone I have no hope to chant the holy names of Sri Hari. Please be merciful to me, and with a particle of faith, give me the treasure of the holy name of Lord Krishna.
Oh, Vaishnava.
Should I repeat it?
Yeah, in parts, please.
Okay. Oh, Vaishnav Thakur, alone I have no hope to chant the holy names of Lord Hari.
Oh, Vaishnava Thakur. Ja sam nemam nikakve nade da mogu mantrati sveto ime gospodina Harija.
Therefore, please be merciful unto me.
Zato molim te, budi milostiv prema meni.
And with a particle of faith, give me the treasure of the holy name of Krishna.
I sa mrvicom vjere, daj mi blago svetog imena Krishna.
This is one prayer that I enjoy chanting before I begin my japa every day.
Jedna molitva koju volim mantrati prije nego što počnem džapu svaki dan.
And of course we have the prayers to the Shikshastakam, Lord Chaitanya's 8 verses. These are also very powerful mercy expressions that will help us in developing attachment to chanting.
Također imamo I poznate molitve gospodina Chaitanya Sri Shikshastaku, kitice koje su jako moćne I koje će nam pomoći da razvijemo vezanost, privrženost prema mantranju.
Yeah, the Shikshastakam prayers are so powerful that actually in practically all of our temples around the world, we chant the Shikshastakam in the morning before we begin our japa.
Te molitve Shikshastake su tako moćne da u velikom broju naših centara diljem svijeta prije nego što se počne mantra japa se izgovaraju te molitve.
So I would highly recommend devotees to adopt chanting of the Shikshastaka prayers before they chant or any of the authorized prayers that we could offer to Lord Chaitanya, to Srila Prabhupada, to our spiritual master.
I toplo bih preporučio baktama da usvoje tu praksu, da prije nego što počnu mantrati na džapi, recitiraju šikšaštake, molitve šikšaštake ili neke druge preporučene molitve gospodinu Čeitanji, Šila Praupadu ili svom duhovnom učitelju.
And we can also chant prayers while we're chanting japa when we see that the mind is going this way or that way, or for some reason we're not able to stay attentive. We can pray. These prayers are very powerful when offered with complete sincerity.
Isto tako možemo te molitve izgovarati za vrijeme mantranja kada primijetimo da nam je odlutao I da se ne možemo usredotočiti sa pažnjom. Te su molitve jako moćne kada ih izgovaramo iskreno.
One of the advantages we have in this present time period we're in is that many of us are not able to travel around or go out so much. We may have more opportunities and time for spending on chanting.
Jedna od prednosti koju sada imamo u ovom trenutnoj situaciji u svijetu je kada ne možemo putovati ili puno ići van, imamo više vremena I prilike da vrijeme da mantramo.
What I'm saying is that again the same principle is that quantity helps to bring about quality.
I ponovo naglašavam to isto načelo da nam količina pomaže da dosegnemo kakvoću, kvalitetu.
Actually, Srila Prabhupada, when he began the movement back in the 1960s, after a year or so, maybe it was about 2 years, he told the devotees that everyone should chant 64 rounds every day.
I zapravo na početku, kad je Srila Prabhupada osnovao ovaj pokret 60. Godina, on je baktama tražio od bakta da mantraju 64 kruga svaki dan.
Yeah, but the devotees felt, oh, Prabhupada, that is too much. We can't do that. We also have other things to do. So Prabhupada said, okay, then chant 32 rounds every day.
Ali baktama je to bilo previše. Tužili su se Prabhupadu I rekli su mu da imaju I druge stvari za obaviti, da ne mogu toliko puno mantrati. Pa je onda Prabhupada rekao u redu, onda mantrajte 32 kruga dnevno.
Again, the devotees were not willing to accept that and were complaining to Srila Prabhupada. So Prabhupada said 16 and no less.
No, bakteni to nisu uspjeli prihvatiti I žalili su se Srila Prabhupadu I onda je Prabhupada rekao, ok, onda 16, ali ništa manje od toga.
But by listening to Prabhupada and reading his books and hearing about the glories of the Lord, we understand that all your advancement in spiritual life is found in the chanting of the holy name.
Ali slušajući Srila Prabhupada I čitajući njegove knjige, razumijemo da sav naš napredak u duhovnom životu ovisi o mantranju svetog imena.
So we have to practice. And whatever time we put in there for practicing and developing our chanting, it is benefiting. The mind is becoming clear, the heart is becoming purified, and our understanding of how to live from day to day becomes easier and more natural.
Zato moramo vježbati. Energiju koju to uložimo, ona se vraća u tom smislu da nam postaje bistriji, srce čišće I postaje nam jasnije kako rješavati probleme u svakodnevnom životu, kako živjeti.
I was talking to one senior devotee who is a guru in our movement, and many devotees that were under him, disciples and others, were coming to him regularly with different problems.
Razgovarao sam sa jednim baktom u našem pokretu koji je guru I on je na takvom položaju da su mu često bakte dolazili sa različitim problemima.
So he was thinking, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to give all my classes for the next year on the importance and glories of chanting Hare Krishna.
I onda je zaključio da će sljedeću godinu sva predavanja koje bude održati na temu slava I značaja mantranja Hare Krishna.
So he did for a whole year, every class he gave, he spoke on the glories of the holy name.
to i napravio cijelu godinu, svako predavanje koje je održao bilo je o slavama svetog imena.
And then he told me this directly, he said, after that, 50% of the problems were reduced.
I nakon toga, rekao mi je on to osobno, 50% problema se smanjili, problemi su se smanjili za 50%.
So there's really no problems once we're chanting the holy names of the Lord and tasting the happiness of chanting. This, as Bhakti Vinod Thakur sings, Enechi Asari Maya, Nasi Bara Lagi, Harinama Maha Mantra, Lao Tumi Magi. It is the medicine. Al Saudi means medicine in this age, which keeps away the effects of the material energy and gives us the taste of the happiness of devotion.
Mantranje svetog imena je lijek u ovom dobu koji uklanja učinke ovog doba i daje nam ukus tog slatkog mantranja svetog imena. I sreću i predanost.
So we can speak all night and even through the night and tomorrow about the glories and activities and the process of chanting the holy names of the Lord. Because it's unlimited. It is the process itself and it's the essence of the process at the same time.
Možemo govoriti cijelu noć još više od toga o slavama, aktivnostima i procesu mantranja svetog imena, zato je to beskonačno.
Until we become convinced about that, our progress in Krishna consciousness will be very, very slow.
Jer je mantranje suština samog našeg procesa predanog služenja i dok u to ne postanemo uvjereni, naš će napredak biti jako, jako spor.
And this is the special mercy in this age given to us by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who has come to practice the chanting of the holy names and demonstrate in his own life and at the same time teach the principles of glorifying Krishna by chanting the holy names as the main way to glorify Krishna in this age, in the best way. Not only main way, but the best way.
To je glavni poklon koji nam je dao Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, koji je došao i svojim primjerom pokazao na koji način se slavi sveto ime, na koji način se mantra, pokazujući nam na taj način najbolji put samospoznaje.
Okay, so I thought I'll stop there and see if there's any discussion, comments or questions related to the topic.
Ostavit ću se ovdje da vidim da li ima kakvih pitanja, komentara ili diskusije povezane sa ovom temom.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble blessings of glory to Srila Prabhupada. I had recently a discussion about chanting of the holy names. And someone told me, oh, I have chanted so many years. Now I stopped. I didn't see any development. So how can we see if we make some progress or not? And can we measure it somehow? Or can someone tell us, for example, our guru or our authority, can someone tell us if we make some progress?
Progress is understood in different ways. You can translate that, Vinata.
Nedavno sam imala neki razgovor o tome s nekim baktom koji je rekao da je toliko dugo mantra, ali da se ništa ne događa. I zanima me da li postoje nekakvi pokazatelji pomoću kojih možemo vidjeti koliko smo napredovali tome, da nam to netko može reći, naš guru, ili na koji način to možemo otkriti.
Yeah, it's how eager we are to serve, how eager we are to associate, how eager we are to chant are indications of our progress.
Pokazatelji našeg napretka je koliko žarko želimo služiti, koliko žarko želimo se družiti s baktama i koliko želimo mantrati.
Yeah, that eagerness is the nature of the soul's expression for Krishna.
Ta revnost, ta želja je izraz dušine želje za Krišnom.
How much we are developing the qualities of a Vaishnava, how much we're losing our attraction for material life.
Koliko razvijamo osobine vajšnave, koliko gubimo privlačnost prema materijalnom životu.
These are also indications of progress.
To su pokazatelji našeg napretka.
It's easy. You can understand material life is like a fever, which a fever is a disease. So when the fever is high, one cannot taste food when eating becomes difficult or not at all. But as the fever goes down, the appetite returns and then the food tastes again, nice. So in the same way, as our fever for material attachments, material activities are reduced, our happiness in Krishna consciousness increases.
Vrlo jednostavno može se usporediti sa stanjem kada smo bolesni, kad imamo visoku temperaturu I zbog nje nemamo nikakvog okusa, hrana nam je bezukusna. Međutim, kako se ta temperatura snizi I vrati se naš apetit, onda ponovno možemo kušati one stvari koje smo prije kuštali. Tako da ta temperatura kad se smanji, onda nestane naš interes za materijalne aktivnosti I pojavi se sreća predanog služenja.
So when your friend speaks like that, he's never really chanted at all. He thinks he was chanting, but he's chanting with offense. And when offenses are there, there's hardly any or very little attraction for chanting.
Ako tvoj prijatelj govori to što si spomenula, to pokazuje da on zapravo nikada I nije stvarno mantrao, odnosno da je mantrao sa uvredama. A kad su uvrede prisutne, onda nema nikakvog ukusa ili vrlo malo ukusa za mantranje.
So we should understand how to approach the holy name and become determined to follow the process of proper chanting.
Trebamo razumjeti kako prići svetom imenu I postati odlučni da slijedimo taj postupak ispravnog mantranja.
The chanting works for everyone, provided they have faith and they are sincerely trying.
Mantranje funkcionira za svakog ukoliko imaju vjeru I ako se iskreno trude.
We have no faith in the holy name, then we'll give up when things become difficult.
Ako nemamo vjere u sveto ime, onda ćemo odustati kad postane teško.
It's a matter of having faith, therefore we have to hear about the glories of the holy name in the association of devotees so we can understand what we have as at our disposal. That is the glory, that is the mercy of the holy name.
Važno je imati vjeru. Da bismo dobili vjeru, trebamo slušati o slavama svetog imena u društvu sa baktama, kako bismo postali svjesni toga što imamo, a to je milost svetog imena.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So does it depend on our motivation, our wishes, our desires?
Yeah, it depends a lot upon them.
Ovisi li to o našoj motivaciji, o našim željama? Da, puno ovisi o tome.
Yeah. We have to desire to chant attentively. We have to be determined to develop it. And we have to have faith that Krishna is there in the holy name.
Trebamo željeti mantrati pažljivo, trebamo odlučiti to razviti, takvo mantranje I trebamo imati vjeru da je Krishna u svom imenu, svetom imenu.
So hearing the glories of the holy name, hearing about the practice of chanting the holy name, is something that we have to do regularly in order to be reminded what we have at our disposal that is the most important part of our practice of spiritual life.
I zato moramo redovno svakodnevno slušati o slavama svetog imena I o toj praksi mantranja svetog imena, kako bismo se podsjetili da je to najvažniji dio našeg duhovnog života.
And of course, association with devotees gives us that faith, that inspiration.
I druženje sa baktama nam naravno daje tu vjeru I tu inspiraciju.
If we don't take enough time to associate with devotees, then we will lose the enthusiasm for chanting.
Ako ne odvojimo dovoljno vremena za druženje s bhaktama, izgubit ćemo polet za mantranje.
It's a process. It's not just chanting. There's things that support chanting and there's things that take away from chanting. We have to understand those two categories.
To je postupak, nije samo mantranje. Ima stvari koje podupiru mantranje i koje ometaju mantranje. I trebamo razumjeti te dvije kategorije.
Thank you very much.
Other question possible?
Yeah.
Hare Krishna, please accept my humble obeisances. I have a question from a friend. He is hesitating to chant because he said that the chanting of Maha Mantra will destroy his material desires, and he is a family man. And he needs material motivations, but then the problem is that chanting Maha Mantra with material motivations is offensive to the holy name. So I don't know what to tell him.
Prijatelja koji kaže oklijeva sa mantranjem zato jer se boji da će mantranje uništiti njegove materialne želje. On je obiteljski čovjek i trebaju mu materialne motivi. A opet mantranje sa tim materialnim motivima je uvreda svetom imenu i onda ne znam šta da mu zapravo kažem.
There is a verse in the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Let me think of that verse. The kama sarva karma uva, moksha karma udaradi, tivrena bhakti yogena, yajeta purusham puram. Whether one has all material desires, no material desires, or one desires liberation, one should follow the process of bhakti and chant the holy names of the Lord.
U drugom pjevanju Šrimad Bhagavatama nalazi se kritica koja kaže da bilo da smo puni materialnih želja, da nemamo nikakve materialne želje ili želimo oslobođenje, trebamo slijediti proces bhakti i mantra sveto ime.
No one is excluded from chanting. Everyone can chant, even those who are full of material desires.
Nikome nije zabranjeno mantranje svetog imena. Svatko može mantrati, čak i onaj koji je pun materialnih želja.
Many of us who are practicing Krishna consciousness, we came with many material desires.
Mnogi od nas koji prakticiramo svjesnost Krišne, došli smo sa puno materialnih želja.
And we practiced, and then of course we develop spiritual desires.
I onda prakticiramo i naravno na taj način razvijemo duhovne želje.
So, if he's afraid of losing his material desires, he doesn't understand that there is something better, something higher.
Ako se osoba boji izgubiti svoje materialne želje, to znači da ne razumije da postoji nešto bolje i nešto više.
A man who is hungry, he'll, if he hasn't eaten for a long time, and whatever you offer him, he'll take because he needs to eat something because of his hunger.
Kad je čovjek gladan i dugo vremena nije jeo, što god da mu ponudite, on će uzeti jer je gladan, mora nešto uzeti.
But if you give him something that he likes, he will choose that above everything else.
Ali ako mu date nešto što on voli, onda će prije svega drugog uzeti to.
So chanting gives you the higher taste.
Mantranje nam daje viši ukus.
Yeah, so we shouldn't worry that, you know, just chant and Krishna will guide you. And it's not that he is going to make your material life difficult. He's going to fulfill your desires for material stability. In other words, you'll get what you need materially, but at the same time, you'll make progress spiritually.
Zato trebamo mantrat i Krishna će se pobrinuti za nas, ispunit će one naše želje za materialnom stabilnošću, odnosno dobit ćemo ono što nam je potrebno, a istovremeno ćemo i duhovno napredovati.
Krishna contains everything, both spiritual and material, because he's the source of both.
Krishna sve sadrži, i duhovno i materijalno, jer je izvor svega.
There is no worry about losing or not gaining. Everything is there in Krishna.
Zato se ne treba bojati da ćemo nešto izgubiti ili da nećemo dobiti, jer u Krišni je sve.
So you can encourage him that there's no offense and there's no loss, simply chant, that's all. And then let him decide for himself based on his own experiences.
I zato možeš prijatelja ohrabriti da mantra, da neće ništa izgubiti time i ne, da to nije nikakva uvreda. A onda on će poslije toga odlučiti na temelju svog vlastitog iskustva.
Okay.
May I ask a question, Maharaj?
Yes, yes, please.
Mm-hmm. I would like, sometimes we read that Prabhupada says we should, while we are chanting, we should just hear. But then there are some conversations where he says that one can imagine worshiping the Lord or something like that. So what is the advice for us? Should we?
Well, to put the form of the Lord in your mind while you're chanting is a very high form of practice. So to get to that stage of meditation, or what we say, the form appearing in the mind, we have to hear. So hearing is the process which leads to these higher stages of meditation on the form of the Lord.
Okay, moje pitanje je bilo da ponekad čitamo kako je Prabhupada savjetovao da trebamo samo slušati dok mantramo, a na drugim mjestima je izgledalo da možemo zamišljati gospodina ili obožavanje njega i tako nešto. Što je savjet za nas? Maharaj kaže da je trenutak u kojem se gospodinov oblik pojavljuje u našem umu samo od sebe vrlo uzvišeni oblik meditacije i da bismo do njega došli trebamo samo mantrati i slušati.
From the holy name the form is revealed. As the form becomes intensified in the mind of the devotee, Krishna's qualities start to manifest and one can understand Krishna within the heart. And as his qualities come, then his pastimes come. Each of these have a lesser and lesser appearance, but each of them are dependent on the previous ones. So everything starts with hearing the holy name.
Sveto ime razotkriva gospodinov oblik, a onda nakon toga počinjemo, kad nastavimo mantra, počinju se razotkrivati njegove osobine, nakon toga njegove zabave. Sve se to odvija postupno, a sve počinje sa slušanjem svetog imena.
Hmm. Does that help?
Yeah, but this is one thing, that the holy name appears by itself.
Yeah, it's independent.
But sometimes devotees like have a picture of the Lord in front, they look at
it. That's fine. What Prabhupada is saying, that Prabhupada is also mentions in the Bhagavatam that we should, at least in the beginning stages of our practice, shouldn't try to see the form of the Lord in the mind while we're chanting. It will be very difficult to keep that manifestation and we'll go in and out of the chanting. Better to work on the hearing process, and then when the hearing becomes stronger, as Prabhupada mentions, then Krishna appears within the mind according to a form that you recognize.
Ja sam rekla da ponekad bhakti imaju sliku ispred sebe dok mantraju. Maharaj je rekao da je to u redu, ali da Šila Prabhupada objašnjava da na početku, na početnim fazama mantranja, se ne trebamo truditi tome da zadržimo u svom umu Krišnin oblik, jer da će nas to ometati u mantranju, u slušanju, i da trebamo mantrat dok se Krišna sam ne razotkrije u umu.
Yeah, it's nothing wrong, and it's actually recommended if you want to keep an external form of the Lord, such as a deity or a picture, in front of you, that's fine, that's good.
Nema ništa lošeg u tome ako ispred sebe imaš dok mantraš, imaš sliku Krišne ili mantraš ispred Krišninog oblika božanstva. To je u redu, to je dobro.
Okay, just give me one second. Somebody's at the door and I'll be right back.
Samo jedan tren, netko je na vratima, moram pogledati ko je to.
One of the techniques that helps to hear nicely is closing your eyes, which helps to shut out the external environment. But if you have a picture of the Lord in front of you, that's fine.
Jedna od tehnika koja pomaže da dobro čuješ je da zatvoriš oči kako okolina ne bi na tebe utjecala. Ali ako ih držiš otvorene i pred tobom je slika ili oblik božanstva, to je u redu. Mm-hmm. Does this appearance of the Lord in the mind by its own will correspond to some stages of development from Shraddha to Prema? Da li pojava gospodina umu njegovom voljom odgovara nekom stupnju napretka od Shraddhe do Preme?
I'm sure there is, but it's more like what is called the different stages of rememberings. There are different stages of, there are five stages of remembering. And so when the form becomes fixed in the mind, that's, I think, that is called, first there is remembrance, then there's absorption, and then there's meditation. So as the stages increase, the intensity or the continuous appearance of that form remains within the mind. So you come to the stage of samadhi, and then you are fully absorbed in that. So it's more like the stages of remembrance, and these are mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
Yes. Da, sigurno odgovara i nekom stupnju napretka, ali više se to odnosi na stupnjeve sjećanja koji su spomenuti u Srimad Bhagavatamu, koji idu od sjećanja za okupljenosti meditacije i kako se više ta meditacija intenzivira, tako je gospodinov oblik postojanije prisutan u našem umu i na kraju završava sa samadijem.
So one thing I can say, when you come to the stage of ruchi, which is the fifth stage, then you're pretty much fixed in the process of chanting and serving.
Kada bhakta dođe na stupanj ruchi, koji je peti stupanj, onda je uglavnom usredotočen u procesu mantranja, na proces mantranja i služenja.
Mm-hmm. Until you get past the stage of nishta, nishta means firm faith, we can't remain steady.
Mm-hmm. Dok ne savladamo taj stupanj nishta, po čvrste vjere, ne možemo biti postojani. Are there some indications on which stage we are? Can we observe that, or we should consult with the senior devotee who knows us, or how can we determine where we are on which stage of development?
Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains that, yeah, he mentions that in the Bhajan. That each of the stages of the nine stages of bhakti have their characteristics and symptoms. So one should understand what those characteristics and symptoms are and see, based on that, what level of practice one is at. And then understand what is the next stage. For instance, the stage of nishta. Nishta means they're fixed in their devotional service. While still, they may still be suffering the reactions of offenses, they're not going to, what we say, go in and out of devotional service. They're fixed. Now they've come to the stage of ruchi. Ruchi means there's a sweet taste that develops. And then there's two types of sweet tastes that are mentioned as the characteristic of ruchi. The sweet taste that comes when everything is nicely presented, such as the kirtan, and the sweet taste that comes when, even though things are not nicely presented, still the taste is there because of the presence of the holy name. So if we study Bhaktivinoda Thakur's explanations, which centers around these stages, you'll find that each one has a particular symptoms. And you can read that about that in Jiva Dharma, Bhaktivinoda Thakur's treatise on the whole science of bhakti, all the way from Adaustrada all the way up to prema.
Ok, pitanje je bilo, da li možemo na neki način znati na kojem smo stupnju razvoja postojali neki simptomi i da li to možemo ocijeniti sami ili trebamo prići starijem bhakti koji nas poznaje. Maharaj je rekao da Bhaktivinoda Thakuru u Bhajana Rahasi objašnjava karakteristike i simptome tih devet stupnjeva napretka od šrade do preme i da proučavajući njih možemo ustanoviti na kojem smo mi stupnju. Pa je tako rekao da ljudi na ništi, bhakte na ništi su postojani u predanom služenju i neće otići iz predanog služenja, ali još uvijek su zaglavljeni tu zbog nekih posljedica nekih uvreda koje su počinile. Kad dođu na stupanje ruči, onda osjećaju taj slatki ukus. Govori se o dvije vrste slatkog ukusa. Jedan je taj kada je sve u redu, kao na primjer u kirtanu, kad je izvedba muzički savršena ili kvalitetna, onda osjećamo ukus. Ali kad stvari ne štimaju na tom materijalnom nivou, kad možda ne pjevaju lijepo, onda ne. Ali na drugom stupnju tog ukusa, onda i takva nesavršena izvedba izaziva kod nas ukus, zato jer osjećamo prisustvo svetog imena. I sve to skupa je Bhaktivinoda Thakur objasnio i u svojoj knjizi Jiva Dharma.
Thank you. I'm sorry I was so long on that one.
That's okay. Thank you. Koji je opisao sve stupnjeve od šrade do preme. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hey Krishna, Maharaj, can you hear me?
Yeah, who's speaking?
First of all, I want to apologize because today from beginning was not so good. We have no good sound, actually at all sound from the beginning, and I'm so sorry for that. I hope this is our first time, first trying, and we hope the next time will be better. Thank you very much, and I want to, can I speak in Croatian? Because it's difficult for me with my bad English.
Prije svega bih htjela.
Znači,
samo trend,
bih se vratila na ono pitanje ranije, kad ste razgovarali o tome da neko ostavi mantranje zato što mu se nešto dogodi.
I will go back to the question when you discussed the situation when somebody stops chanting because of things happening in his life.
Prije 9 godina otprilike radili program u zatvoru.
9 years ago we have participated in the prison program.
Bila su nekoliko zatvorenika koja su prisustvovala tom programu.
There were several inmates who were attending those programs.
I dvojica od njih su postala vrlo inspirirana da počnu mantrat.
Two of them became very much inspired for chanting.
I onda smo mi podijelili džape njima dvojici i trebali smo se ponovo vidjeti za tjedan dana.
Then we brought them japa malas and we were supposed to meet in a week again.
Ne, pardon, mjesečno. Jedan put mjesečno, znači za mjesec dana.
Actually not in a week, but in a month. We had monthly programs.
I kad smo došli sljedeći put, jedan od tih zatvorenika nam je automatski vratio džapu.
And next time when we came, one of them immediately gave us this japa mala back.
I rekao je da kad je počeo mantrat, da su mu se počele događati svakakve stvari. Znači, loše stvari.
And he said that when he started with chanting, that many bad things were happening to him.
I mi smo mu pokušali reći da je to možda zato što se ubrzava njegova karma ili nešto, neka nastavi, neka ne stane. Međutim, nije htio čuti.
We tried to explain to him that it might be because of some kind of acceleration of his karma and that if he just goes on, it will become better, but he did not agree.
Kako onda postupiti u tim slučajevima?
What to do in such a situation?
What can you do?
Što možeš napraviti?
Well, just tell him that because you have no faith, it's not working. As soon as you have faith, it'll start working.
Jednostavno mu reci, zato što nemaš vjere, ne funkcionira. Čim stekneš vjeru, će proraditi.
Sometimes people chant just to see what they can get from the chanting.
Ponekad ljudi mantraju samo da vide što mogu dobiti od mantranja.
What they can get materially.
U materijalnom pogledu što mogu dobiti.
And so we don't really know what is his motivation, but if he just chants, just forgetting about anything, just chant for the sake of chanting, gradually things will change.
Ne znamo s kojim motivima je on mantrao, ali ako netko mantra samo zbog mantranja, postupno će se stvari promijeniti.
He hasn't really given it a chance. That's the problem.
On nije zapravo pravo niti pokušao. U tome je problem.
And a lot of times we understand that when you begin chanting, your bad karma starts to go, or the effects of your bad karma start to go. And then what happens? It feels like, just like if you have a disease, and you're taking medicine, sometimes it appears the disease is getting worse because the disease is coming out.
Puno puta kada mantramo, može se dogoditi da počne odlaziti naša loša karma, i onda se čini kao da se stvari pogoršavaju. Baš kao kad uzimamo neki lijek jer smo bolesni, i onda u prvom trenu može doći do pogoršanja, ali ono je indikacija da je sve u redu.
So those who are more sinful, they will take longer.
Za one koji su grešni, njima će dulje trajati.
Just try to encourage him that don't be discouraged. Keep trying. You can give them examples from your own experience so they become a little convinced.
Možeš mu ga ohrabriti da nastavi tako što mu ispričaš neka vlastita iskustva koja će mu pomoći da steknu vjeru.
Or you can start feeding him prasadam, and if he takes prasadam long enough, then he might develop some faith in the chanting.
Ili ga možeš početi hraniti sa prasadamom i ako dovoljno dugo uzima prasadam, on će možda razviti vjeru u mantranje.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Very well, Malati. Okay, did we exhaust all our questions?
Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to you, Guru Maharaj. Thank you for this wonderful lecture on chanting the holy name. I heard that slowly as we continue chanting, Krishna's form, then qualities, then pastimes will appear in the heart. I want to know what exactly is meant when we say Krishna's qualities. Does that mean that we experience Krishna's qualities or we acquire some of Krishna's qualities? What does that look like?
Opis hvalati na jako lepoj lekciji. Hvala vam na lepoj lekciji. Čula sam da kako mantramo, tako će se polako u našem srcu početi pokazivati Krišni na no, ime, oblik, osobine I zabave. Zanima me kako se to pokazuju osobine. Da li to znači da smo u stanju da cijenimo te osobine ili da mi dobijemo te osobine? Na koji način je ta pojava osobina u našem srcu?
Yeah, it's that simple. As you get to know a person, then you start knowing about the person. So you might meet a person, you don't know much about him. And you know he's kind, he's generous, he likes to do this. He has, these are his activities. Yeah, so you start to understand what are Krishna's qualities.
Zapravo jako jednostavno, kao kad poznaješ neku osobu I onda sviđati se I postupno upoznaješ njegove osobine. Tako znaš da je on ljubazan, da je velikodušan. Da, jednostavno upoznaješ Krišnine osobine.
Mm-hmm. And because you're part and parcel of Krishna, you have some of those qualities, not all of them, in minute qualities. So you may also experience some of these qualities of Krishna, which are in you in small proportion also.
Obzirom da se Krišnin sastavni dio, onda I ti imaš te osobine u nekoj maloj mjeri, tako da možeš to doživjeti, te osobine kod sebe u nekoj manjoj mjeri nego.
Okay, thank you, Guru Maharaj.
You don't sound convinced.
Ne zvučiš baš da si uvjerena u to.
I'm just thinking that maybe there's a block somewhere because though I'm chanting, am I really getting to know Krishna? I don't know that I'm getting to know Krishna, which means there's some block somewhere.
Ma, čini mi se kao da ima neki, da me nešto blokira, da me nešto zaustavlja, jer iako mantram ne izgleda baš da upoznajem Krišnu, kao da je nešto sprečava.
It could be true. There could be something there that's blocking your progress in chanting.
Može biti da je to istina. Može biti nešto što blokira tvoj napredak u mantranju.
Could be inattentive chanting.
Može biti nepažljivo mantranje.
Attachment to the results of activities.
Vezano za rezultate aktivnosti. Mm-hmm.
But if you work on attention and stay fixed on developing attention, it will manifest. And as attention increases and everything, Krishna reveals himself in these different manifestations of himself, such as his names, his forms, his qualities, past and.
Ali ako radiš na tome da budeš pažljiva, sve će se dovesti u red. Kako pažnja bude se povećavala, onda Krišna će biti zadovoljan I on će se razotkriti ne samo njegovo ime, nego I oblik, osobina I zabave. Mm-hmm.
Faith is there, determination is there, but maybe some wrong activities are also present. You have to see.
Vjeru imaš, odlučnost imaš, možda I neke stvari krivo radiš, treba vidjeti.
Or wrong mentality.
Ili imaš krivi stav, mentalitet.
Okay, Guru Maharaj.
I would suggest, knowing you a little bit, I would suggest you chant faster.
Na osnovu onog koliko te poznajem, savjetovao bih da brže mantraš.
I think you chant too slow, and because you chant too slow, your mind wanders.
Mislim da mantraš presporo I zbog toga ti um luta.
Yes, Guru Maharaj, I will certainly make that attempt. Thank you so much.
Just try to hear, get the sound down, and then just try to increase the speed a little, and it becomes easier to stay fixed on the chanting.
Pokušavaj slušati I malo samo ubrzaj, povećaj brzinu I onda ćeš vidjeti da je lakše ostati usredotočen na mantranje.
And make sure you get enough rest.
I budi siguran da imaš dovoljno, da se dovoljno odmaraš.
Yes, Guru Maharaj, that is very important. That's something I have to take care of.
Da, Guru Maharaj, imaš pravo, to je jako važno, moram se za to pobrinuti.
Hare Krishna. Okay, I think maybe we can stop here.
Mislim da sam
postavio. Thank you, Vinata. I really appreciate your translations. You're the only one that doesn't complain that I give long sentences.
That's because I'm almost 60 years old. When I was younger, I was complaining too.
I try not to do that, but it happens anyway.
No problem.
Good. Thank you to all the devotees, my obeisances, and try to remember the importance of the holy name as the focus of everything we do in Krishna consciousness.
Hvala vam svima, primite moje poštovanje I pokušajte se sjetiti da je sveto ime središnja točka u svemu što mi radimo u našem predanom služenju.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Can I thank you for your you share your wisdom and realization with us. I hope we meet again very soon.
Thank you. It was my pleasure to be able to have the association of all the devotees. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Guru Maharaj.
Thank you.
Thank you, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Postavanya.
Hare Krishna.